Some customers keeping the cash.
We're live? We're on?
Yeah, no, we're so very live.
How long have we been live?
We are from seconds.
Did I say the N-word at all?
Research shows that being exposed to rude behavior can make you less likely to be helpful.
So she would have been nicer. You think it would have played out differently?
Hi.
Yes, on everything that else. That's all that matters.
Hey, thanks for coming. Our last show.
Hi, guys. Welcome to the final episode. Premiere of...
Final new episode. Yes.
There we go.
Of season one.
Yeah. Hacking the system. Of the first full season. I mean, I guess we had the first two episodes.
Which some people call this season two. And then those two were like little bastard proof of concept. They were specials.
Well, like in my mind, those specials were the beginning of season one. Now we're completing the complete art.
Even though if you go to purchase them on Google Play, Amazon, or what have you.
You can watch them on Hulu.
But even if you go to like Amazon. Oh, here we go. If you go to Amazon or what have you, the first two episodes aren't available.
Those original two.
Oh, dude. I wonder where those are.
Need some extra cash? Who doesn't?
By the way, in the early cut of this, it was $100,000. You can tell it's like a copyright free version money right now.
To your car, to things we don't even think about, like drinks, haircuts, or even mattresses.
Oh shit, I forgot about the awesome Diamond Club references that I dropped in this. Yeah.
We also have a good story about the mattresses.
You are owed $100 by the state of Texas.
Oh shit, yes!
I'm Brian Brushwood.
Holy cow, yeah, no, that was definitely a thing.
Of criminals and con artists.
Apparently, like, if somebody comes
and dangerous stunts as a professional magician.
Hold it.
Now I have
Holding an encyclopedia
of shortcuts.
Hold.
Secret data.
Hold.
And helpful hacks designed to help you.
Yeah, there was lots of stuff that we could not
give
do.
You the upper hand.
On this one as well.
This is all the hacking the system.
This one was, you know, I wanted to do, well, here's how you really counterfeit, if you want to do it.
Dude, that was like literally, but here's the way you're going to get caught. Specifically, each individual inkjet printer puts a serial code embedded in all of everything it prints.
You know, it's been like that for
like 20 years. That stuff was in our original write-up for Court TV back in the day. Yeah.
$6,000
or reduced 50% to $3,000.
Yeah.
This guy.
He's the real deal.
I had a hard time because it kept cracking up.
Sellers get the best of us by making it nearly impossible to compare prices. This is because manufacturers will sell the exact same mattress to different resellers under different.
No.
So how are we supposed to know whether the turquoise sleep is really just the?
Oh no!
Only one way to find out.
Ah, dang it! Whether the turquoise sleep is really just the The reference I was making was Fucktron 9000. But, I mean, like, we
or
had...
Or just you got blipped out or whatever?
Yeah.
Well, now that we have
but that's definitely a reference to Turquoise Jeep right there.
$500 more. Mattress 2? You're going down.
Turquoise Sleep versus the, Man, I wish I knew what I said.
Well, that was highly unpractical and a lot of work.
At this mattress store, we found out that they often shoot pornography there.
Yeah, look, it turns out that there's a reason they were okay with us putting cameras all over the place.
They're used to it. And I heard that as I was sitting on one of the beds backstage, and I was like, I'm gonna get up. Does anyone have any Purell?
Expose some of the cheap tricks of the mattress trade.
Take the extended warranty. You want a king, sir? Have you ever fallen asleep on a cloud?
Give the king a shot.
You don't sleep, you drift, is what he said. On a cloud.
Yeah, that guy was amazing.
This
mattress mayhem
was so sure of his team sales technique.
Completely not what I was expecting.
have you seen this one yet?
Here's what I found.
Oh shoot!
I don't think.
Maybe
I saw an early cut of it.
Pretty nice bounce, huh?
Yeah, man.
Oh, I'm Kent. Welcome to Mattress City. And can I say something?
What's that?
You look like a man of quality. You ever gone to a VIP room in a club?
I have.
Well,
champagne room.
Yeah, right. There's no sex in the champagne room. However, there will be sex on this mattress. Yeah, no.
If the Blu-ray has this, if the Blu-ray ever comes out and has it, it'll be right after that. The guy actually said, "We'll step right back here and let me introduce you to cinnamon."
If this happens to you,
that's how they do it in North Hollywood.
Let's start with what size looking for. You looking for queen? Looking for king?
Know what size you want before you start shopping. If you're a big person and you have the space and
what
extra
size
bucks,
mattress?
Sure, go for
queen,
a king.
Oh, dude, I
queen. I'm more like
queen
an
it up.
Person
queen.
Interested in a queen size.
We're king.
Are you looking for twin? Is it for you? For your wife? For the kids?
To be honest, I'm more concerned with like how they feel. You know, kind of like getting a little sample.
Wait, are you guys king
size? Exactly
you're
May
floppers.
May I suggest starting off on this pillow top mattress? It's a medium firm.
Can I tell you our secret?
How does it support?
Sleep in different
rooms. It's very comfortable.
I highly recommend it.
Now there are specialty mattresses that cost more, but most.
You can flop around the bed all you want, and the other
design.
Person
it
just
depends
is
on
not
your
there.
Budget and what feels comfortable to you.
I roar. That's bad apnea.
The
it
best
sounds
way
like
to
nothing
test it is to literally fall asleep on it.
Can
I'm
create.
Not joking. Don't be shy. Just take a snooze.
She does have audio
if
and
it feels
video.
Good after a nap, it'll likely feel good after a full night's sleep.
I also sleep punch, though. I've hit her room.
How much are we looking at? Well, we're looking at something that's not going to be here by 1 o'clock. It's a sale for $1,100. That's 50% off the regular price.
Ugh, mattress shopping is exhausting. Let's take a break and check out some quick and easy hacks at home that could save you hundreds of bucks
a
year.
Remember we ran around, was it Paul's place?
Want to save money using your home entertainment system? Don't worry, not going to tell you to cancel cable.
That was my favorite line that I snuck in there. I'm so excited that that showed up. That's amazing.
Replacing 100 watt bulbs throughout your house with compact
fluorescents
or LEDs
all this
is will save you $150
I was near
the first year alone.
Oh, wait. Oh, my God.
Switching
that's
all your
right.
Cleaning supplies to generics can save you over $380 a year. Or heck, you can even improvise your own. Lemons can eliminate hard
like
water
that.
Stains.
Tom, smells my co-host.
Nice got to admit, not a fan of this one. But if you want serious power savings,
that was very specifically in that moment. I was just like, what is something that I can say that will? No, I'm so excited about that moment.
To 68, because every degree above uses that same extra 3 to 4%. Washing your clothes in cold water instead of hot water could save you $30 a year in energy costs. And get this, just keeping your lint trap clean.
Not washing your clothes at all can save you even more.
Yeah.
Here's a ridiculously easy way to save $50 a year. Keep your closets closed. That's how much energy is wasted heating and cooling that space.
Also, monsters.
Yeah.
Just a few simple tricks. I cut about $694 from my home's annual expenses. And that's just the tip of the iceberg. I've shown you how to save money around the house.
Washed his bedsheets once.
But wouldn't it be nice to shave something off the mortgage payments too? Instead of making single monthly payments, make a half payment every other week. Here's how it works out. If you're paying monthly, you're only making 12
dude, I was,
payments
all
per
I could think about
year.
Was how shitty my handwriting
week,
is. Like, the entire time I'm doing
it
like, national television, my shitty handwriting.
Psychologically, you'll
you
barely notice anything's
double.
Different.
Dude, well, and plus also, it's like,
it
was
chalk, and over the life of the mortgage, it
you know, whatever, chalk paint pen. But even as I was doing this, I was like, dude, there's no amount
over the
of this. There's no redos. I knew it was like, it was just one. There's a diamond down in the corner. Yeah, I wrote OMG.
Of course, saving money isn't the only way to own your own home. One guy bartered his way to owning a house.
Dude,
what was
I totally
the first
knew
item
this.
He started with? Was it a red paper clip?
Oh, yeah.
A luxury
this is
sedan,
internet legend.
An
yeah,
oil
do you remember?
I do. Okay. Very much, yeah.
Yeah, dude, everybody knew it. Yeah. That's amazing.
A single red paper clip. A man from Montreal started with a red paper clip, and 14 trades later, he landed the biggest trade of them all.
17 trades
a
later, he was able to
house.
Buy some orphans
I bet
from
he
Cambodia.
Never had to haggle with a
20 trades later, also
speaking
he's
which,
God.
Let's get back to the mattress mayhem. My budget's around $1,000, so I'm getting closer, but
God,
I still want a better deal.
What do you think so far?
Well, I think I've nailed it down to one of these
greasy.
Three guys.
How many coils are you looking for?
As many as it takes.
800 coils, 600 coils, 500 coils. The more coils, it's going to be the firmer the mattress.
Okay. So long as you have a minimum number of coils, 500 is a good amount, it should be a decent mattress. anything above that
coil?
Is just a matter of how it feels to you.
Just what I'll balance. I'm really good. Sort of laying back. I thought this was still the show for a second. Yeah. I was very confused. Dude, so I guess this episode I know ends with us on the Hollywood Strip, right? Like you're underwater.
You know?
Yeah.
Mr. Muscles?
I wasn't there. So you can
Wait. Yeah,
I was there, but I wasn't the pharmacy there.
You weren't on.
Right.
Yeah.
I was in the air conditioning.
Yeah.
Because it was horrible.
Oh, everything, all I remember. Like, I kept going into... They chewed us out because I kept going into the Express for Men. And they were like, hey, it's great that you want to hang out here. However, every time you come in, it registers you as a customer coming in.
Oh,
and it totally fucks up my sales metrics.
Yeah.
So could you... not be here.
What are like that's interesting.
Yeah, that was fucked up. Tips that
make your life God, the Hollywood Strip, man. Thousands on your next so much that was trash.
So
tell me.
This is like
neon.
People.
Nice drop off whatever adjective you were trying to come up with there.
Just there's a lot of people. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah, it was just like, so much garbage. Like, hey, here's if you want to buy a coffee mug with a gold embossed Marilyn Monroe on it, or a pencil, says "Hooray for Hollywood" on it. It's just like just garbage.
Yeah, dude.
And it's all like overpriced and ridiculous.
And the majority of people were clear or almost clear in just 4 months. Humira can lower your ability to fight infections, including tuberculosis. Serious, sometimes fatal infections and cancers, including lymphoma, have happened, as have blood, liver, and nervous system problems, serious allergic reactions, and new or worsening heart failure. Before treatment, get tested for TB. Tell your doctor if you've been to areas where certain fungal infections are common, and if you've had TB, hepatitis B, are prone to infections, or have flu-like symptoms or sores. Don't start Humira if you have an infection.
Set a new goal. What kind of ad do we have going on now?
Dude, let me tell you, dude.
Okay.
You know, wrong with Humira?
I was like,
look at how it enables people.
Would you be willing to give up sharing your moment?
What?
I don't like to share.
Sacrifice streaming all night long.
What?
Is everyone watching?
Is it okay to drop a connection?
No, it's not. You need it most. Ever. It's never okay.
If you're not on the largest,
I didn't know you brought your laptop, dude.
What are you
see?
Giving
she's
Allison
clearly
is,
not yeah, willing Verizon. To give up her connection. She needs Verizon.
Wait, this again?
Dude.
Heineken?
Doing the ad.
It's become...
No harm had. That was a double whammy.
There you go. That was a Steve original.
Yep.
Wait, what's happening here?
It's about killing Jesus.
Oh, we are going to hack the crucifixion.
Let's
Season 2, Hacking the Crucifixion.
The Son of God. Yeah. You got any gum?
One of the episodes we pitched was How to Start a Cult.
That's actually not even a lie.
Not a joke. Didn't make it very far
trying to
in the
hack
approval
my way
process.
To a decent deal on a mattress. And this salesman's revealing every trick and tactic in the playbook to make me spend more.
This is the one. I want this bed in the queen size.
May I stop you, sir? You want a king, sir.
Yeah. Dude, you're huge. This guy is unbelievable. He's still trying to tell me what I want and upsell me to a more expensive item.
He is
when
smooth.
A salesman does this to you, stay firm. See what I did there?
To be honest, that was also not they written into the script. So, the script said stay firm, and I was like,
buying an extended warranty isn't necessarily worth it because it doesn't cover wear and tear. But do
stay
make
girthy.
Sure there's a label sewn into the fabric. If there's no label, do not buy the mattress. It's likely to be used or recycled, and you'll have no recourse if it's defective.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to go with this bed and no extended warranty.
Take it off my hands today. We get it for 40% off, $900.
Is this the manufacturer's minimum price?
Asking about the manufacturer's price lets him know that I'm an informed buyer and that I demand a good deal.
Well, it's the most my manager will allow me
with
to
take. Glove.
That goes out of my price range.
Sir, that is an insult. I demand retribution at dawn.
You should be able to negotiate a fair price.
Well, listen, I'm going to give you an additional.
Doesn't this salesman
discount.
Know Schwartz is a size queen?
I think we have a deal.
Maybe.
Appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
Finally, once he realized I couldn't be intimidated, I got the price I wanted. I saved 50% on a mattress that usually sells for $1,800. That's $900 of savings. Not bad for an hour's work. I'll sleep well tonight, knowing that so far my hacks have saved me nearly 25 grand.
Yeah, that's cool. Got the running total down there.
Now
yeah.
You want a cup of coffee. One report reveals that we spend almost as much on a Java Jolt per year as we do on commuting.
What?
We all know that cutting out expensive treats
depends
adds
on what
up.
City you're in,
but here's
though.
A reminder of
whether
just
or not
how
you
much.
Have Jason Murphy driving you around everywhere.
Well, if you have your
you
your,
sit there, are you
your
counting
own hamburger Tiananmen Square?
Just $5 a week invested at 8% in 5 years turns into $1,596. After 20 years, it's nearly $13,000. Keep doing it for 30
Listen,
years,
folks.
And you have over $30,000 of cold, hard cash.
I don't like really recognizing
so that,
because I definitely waste more than $4
it's more expensive
a day.
Now.
Although it was fun to grab.
Cutting out fancy drinks may be an option for some of us.
I do not have any sort
food,
of
water, shelter, clothing,
measurement
haircuts.
By...
According to one survey,
how much I spend
hair salons
on
are
dude,
most
wait, there's a great moment where
States.
I give a wink and a nod to the old hairstyle.
Pizza joints oh. And car washes. And some people are spending huge amounts of money to invest in, let's face it, something that's not going to last very long. If you want to save some of that hard-earned cash and put it into something that'll pay a better dividend, I got a hack for you.
Hacking a haircut. Floby.
The Bureau of U.S. Labor Statistics estimates that we're going to need 13% more cosmetologists,
dude, I
barbers,
think that
and hairdressers
is the last time
between 2012
I cut
and
the sides of my hair.
And where do you think
that's
they get
how long
trained?
It's been?
Really?
Yeah.
Like it's getting shaggy.
With a yeah, no, I'm super shaggy
professionals,
shaggy.
There's thousands of schools
I'm
like
okay
this all
this.
Over the country. You can often get a great haircut for free or just pay a small tip. And if you don't like it, in 4 weeks you can try again. The average guy spends $20
tried my best to make it look like the spiked hair.
You need the beeswax.
Yeah.
Over the course of 30 years, this one trick could save you $10,000 or more for a once-a-month trim.
Yeah.
I like
I
it.
I think that was an
ADR. Good.
Just kidding.
Nice job, Nydia.
Thank you.
Cost of my haircut?
Hey, baby.
$0. Of course, I did leave a tip in cash. Now, we
yeah,
can't talk
come on
about
over.
Financial hacks without mentioning those little cards that put the average American household into, oh, I don't know, just $15,000 worth of debt.
Yeah.
Bum, bum, bum. Credit cards. If you're like most Americans, they make it way too easy to impulse buy and rack up the debt. Jason, what's the last thing you bought with
yeah.
your credit card?
What can you do?
It was a Mr. T alarm clock.
Why am I not surprised?
It's an alarm clock, but it's Mr. T, and it says, I pity the... It sounds stupid.
I love the fact that you got halfway through the phrase.
Exactly
I pity the... It sounds stupid.
Maybe regret later. When I was getting out of debt...
I wish
I
actually had a Mr. T alarm clock.
I
yes!
I wanted to
use
one for an emergency, so I used a commitment
yeah,
device.
They were like, hey, I'll make something up. No, Mr. T alarm.
Here we go.
Is that my credit card?
Yep.
Why would you do this?
Because you still have it for emergencies, and if there's something you really want, you have to wait for it to thaw out. And if it is an impulse buy, maybe you'll think twice about that Mr. T alarm clock.
And I don't want to carry around my ice chest while I'm shopping.
Then spend cash. Psychologically, it tricks you into being
dude,
more
by the
frugal.
Way, since
the
doing this,
the denomination
I carry
bill
cash
and the crisper
on me
it is,
all the time.
I know, I've been meaning to start
like,
that.
It seriously makes a difference.
Steal my info
had,
the other day.
Wait, what?
My card.
What?
Yeah. So I start seeing all these charges pop up. That
if freezing your credit card seems a little extreme,
yeah. Yeah.
Another way to
I'm
get
glad this happened before we showed
money.
Your credit card
one
on national television.
One of the best ways to do that
so that, you know, you didn't blame
it.
Me.
My buddy Adam here, he's been working for the same
dude,
company for
this
over
guy,
a year.
Adam?
And while he's been taking on more and more responsibility,
wait,
he
you know
hasn't
the story
been
about
taking
Adam,
in more
right?
cash.
I don't know that I do.
That's
Adam
where I come in.
Is... whatever.
Communist.
No, he's the inspiration for the ballet. You to listen to
my cues. Oh,
he's the one who casually mentioned, like, oh yeah, yeah, yeah. No, 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 I get what you're doing. You're doing stuff like this. He's like, I know the owners, and they're allowing me to monitor events for me. I don't know what I could say, but maybe the phrase "did time" showed up, and followed by an explicit explanation of the ballet bit, and we're like, are you fucking kidding me? And we're blown away.
I didn't meet this guy.
Yeah, no, this guy was awesome. He's dope.
Deep breath, man. You got this. Yours to share. Asking for a raise can be nerve.
Certainly in the county records.
Don't let him get on edge.
All right.
Freedom of Information Act. Here we go. Sweetheart.
Thank you for coming today. I understand the kind of constraints that
this
you're
guy was
under,
great. Adam was really rad.
I also understand if your answer is not right now.
Ah, no! You don't want to start by letting him off the hook.
Way to go, jerk! You ruined it! Real man.
How do the people it's the first look in our new series.
me and Justin, or Jason, goddammit, well, take two. Me and Jason! We have 4,500 extras on set every day. I thought of Jesus, and I thought of Justin's beard. How majestic it was.
It's, yeah.
By the way, I think I'm getting out of the beard game.
No,
I think beards are played out. I'm gonna
I don't think so.
Really?
No, I think all these guys work so hard to get them going that they're not going to give it up without a fight.
That's why I should give it up now. I think it's overplayed.
I have any facial hair just because I haven't gotten around the shaving.
I'm going to do the half stash. I've been threatening for years.
A half stash?
Yeah.
What is that? It's more. Like one half of your face, like a burn victim?
Yeah. Shave your face. Did you know that?
Oops. Like, really can hurt like you. Smooth, like a razor commercial?
Sure, on one why side? Not? Yeah, shave half the head, too.
You should do the monkey tail.
Monkey tail?
Where this part is shaved, right?
Yeah.
But then it comes around, and it's shaved here.
Yeah.
But then it comes around and swirls around your mouth like a monkey tail.
Oh, yeah, so it starts here, goes around, and then maybe up, and then turns into a rat tail.
You could do, that's even more creative. Yeah.
No, I love that.
Yeah.
That's great.
I don't want to be seen with you, but
I think it's totally legit. I'm thrilled that finally you had the courage to say out in public what I've been thinking all these years.
Maybe get some just chops.
Yeah.
Just
wait,
Wolverines.
No. What's funny is I have inverse chops. Look at this. I'm bald, right there.
Yeah. What's up with that?
I don't know.
Is that like contaminated?
I bet I could rock the Tony Wonder. That's what I'm thinking. Is that Ed Harris?
I have.
Wait, is that Captain Malcolm Reynolds?
Was it?
Nope.
That's Liam Neeson. Very different from Nathan Fillion.
Same thing. Whatever. They're all the same bullshit.
This looks good. Looks like the kind of movie Liam Neeson is churning out every month.
Yeah, dude. Does he have a particular set of skills?
I can't grow hair like right here. Bring the delicious this area here. Chocolate.
That's how much you hate Nazism.
Yeah.
You're like, I can't. I'm not physically incapable of growing a Hitler mustache.
Can't rock the Hitler. Try. I've been thinking about cultivating like really long nose hair to fake it.
Oh shit. There's Jay. I wish I could look that dope.
That's how Jay looks right now.
No. That's how he looked, what, 4 years ago?
Okay.
Question mark?
I was about to say,
Louis C.K., man.
That mustache or something.
Dude, that mustache, though, right?
Yeah, I'm really past the whole fetishization of facial hair.
Yeah, right?
In fact.
But Bonnie's like into it. Do you want me to keep it fun?
Just a little bit. I don't like you like smooth to shave.
Right, but I can like 5 o'clock shadow this.
Yeah, yeah.
Bonnie likes Brian's entire body. Hairless as a baby's ass.
Like, look at my glowing chin.
Not too hard to achieve,
my chin should not glow like this. Is
the sober what is your chin doing?
Glowing.
Is it glowing? Spinach.
Mushrooms. Because it's catching the light.
All that facial hair. Yeah.
Oh.
You're just a golden boy over there, Brian. That noise.
Bowl should be slurped with gusto.
Yum. To explore further, order online or visit your neighborhood.
Schwitz shaves will look 14 again. What? Whoa. Awesome.
Save thousands on your next purchase.
That was way too easy.
Hacking the System, another episode.
Oh, cute.
Next,
I think,
on National Geographic.
Josie was inspired because she wrote her own commercial based off the little bits that she put together tonight.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I mean, by the way, the kids have been watching like a scary amount of Hacking the System.
Yeah, they're
like that's
into
that's what
it.
They like they're finding out like different ways, like how do I put it on this iPad, and they're going to YouTube and finding the bootlegs that are uploaded and so on. Yeah. Right at the start.
It's so sweet.
I can give them my unabridged notes.
No.
Jesus, please don't. Open up the lines of
communication. Now we got to see if we can turn this around.
They've got an Etch-a-Sketch, right?
Every all I'm asking from you is
comes a certain age when every kid needs to know how to make thermite.
Asking your boss to be reasonable is a non-threatening way to gain more control over the conversation.
I'm so ready, like I'm so.
Brian looks at Bonnie. No.
That would be irresponsible. But seriously,
let's do it. What are you doing Saturday?
When you hear something like this, it's time to break out your secret weapon. CPI. Mention CPI.
What did he say? When I said, break out your secret weapon, I expected me to walk out.
Anthrax.
A friggin' dachshund. I'm like, it's time to break out the secret weapon.
Mary Todd Lincoln.
Say that same dog from the other bit.
With his overall awareness. Hope it works.
Now he's trying to get a loan here? Is that...
No. He's negotiating a raise, yeah.
Right. I remember that. Okay. I mixed that together because it was originally written, I believe, as part of the How to Get a Job. We had one that was all like Hack the Office Place.
Yeah.
And that got taken and dispersed throughout multiple episodes.
Man, that's the amazing part, is like you come up with all these, I mean, obviously we've organized stuff so that, you know, it's themed together, but all of these begin as individual, like, bits that we notice that are all gathered together.
By asking him to put a value because we had this summer while we were filming, we had a lot of episodes that were scuttled like right before we shot them. Some of them that we had to come up with just completely from scratch,
brand new ideas.
And then others, it was like, well, we can cannibalize stuff from this one and then just disperse them elsewhere. And
Man.
It was very fluid.
Gambling Man points out, he says, only 5 minutes left of the season. Time flies.
Oh,
dude. They cut out right here. I said, dude, you killed it? Or what you see is me saying, dude, you killed it. What I actually said was, dude, you killed it? You buried the body in the desert and nobody ever found it? Or I forget what it was, but it was like super dark.
Which billionaire stays in
they also cut.
You killed it, you slaughtered it, you buried the body in the desert.
Is it you sent threatening Branson, letters to their to the media Biden, and their families.
All right, what's your guess, chat room?
The answer is Frederick Meyer.
Good old Frederick Meyer.
They also cut from the holiday episode. The grocery and merchandise chain. Sweet Beaches.
I mean, you can't blame a guy from that era for buying.
What was that one?
Cars.
Oh.
Is he saying beaches or beaches? But yeah, I don't know what he's saying.
I forgot all about
that. I don't know what he's saying at all.
Smooth. I definitely okay.
And expensive.
There was this moment I wanted to express. Like this Lexus. How surprised I was, and I intended to say sweet beaches, but I definitely could be interpreted as having said sweet beaches.
Yeah.
We have $1,800 in number 19. I need.
But if you're looking for ways to save money,
suppose we have $1,800 going once.
And you do your research.
Yeah,
this was up in Burbank.
You could get a great deal. Dude, this was right around the corner from our friends over at Bandwagon Media, right?
Yeah. And also by that really sketchy bar. That we
dude, the Irish bar, or that one dude, the one dude on the corner, yeah, just
all
shouting nonsense. Oh god damn, that was unreal.
Bank or government auction.
Yeah.
These guys just want to make it
like
an
over.
Yeah.
For no reason.
Do your homework.
He wasn't watching, like, you know, the paper cars are for sale.
And then when we went out, he made sure to give us.
So you could do a complete
really?
Like as a surprise. Whoa.
Yeah. And then it was really super weird.
Like, say something.
Yeah, I dare you to. Come at me, bro.
It was a sketchy bar.
Must have been some kind of special needs dude.
No.
You don't think so?
Special needs to stop drinking.
You don't think he's like Tourette's or something?
Special needs to stop drinking. Yeah, absolutely.
Let's take a look. Here's a counterintuitive one. Check out the radio presets.
I dug this one. This was one of my favorite subtleties.
Maybe the car was owned by somebody older and more responsible, which means proper maintenance.
With a little bit of legwork and
research, I was able to get this car for less than half of its book value. And the best part is, I won't get bent out of shape first time it gets a dent.
Dude, that is, to be honest, like in a world where, within the next 3 or 4 years, we'll be able to start saving for a Tesla. Like, I think, I don't want to save for a Tesla. I'll be really upset when it gets dinged or fucked up or whatever. I'm like, give me an old piece of shit.
And lightning starts shooting out of the hole.
Yes, exactly.
Where they keep track of money from abandoned savings accounts, overpaid bills, uncashed payroll checks, and more.
Oh, here comes. To see how many people this is the big winner.
Yeah. You guys should all, if you're watching this, you should
right
try
now,
this.
Right now,
right now. Right now. Yeah, and let us know how much you can get.
Rezan, where are you from?
I'm from LA.
All it takes is entering your name in an easily searchable database to find out if there's any money owed to you.
It says sorry at this time.
You're not. Did you have anything owed to you, Brad?
No, but Jay showed up.
Hey, yeah.
Jay showed up and Dad What's showed up. Your dad is owed $4.
I am.
Yeah.
I am owed a couple of hundred. I still haven't cashed it in yet.
Hey, boss, I'm Brian. What's your name, sir? Mr. Boss.
It's like for unclaimed cash.
$100.
Oh, really?
What was the website again?
Well, each state has their own website, so it's like unclaimed funds state.
Gosh. Yeah. I think I checked for you,
dude. It's totally not a BS service. It's all legit. It's government money. Yeah. Where it's like it's the responsibility of each state to keep track of what money is owed in unpaid wages, in deposits that are owed back, and all this other shit. Somebody will have a link in the chat room in like 2 seconds.
Yeah. I actually did it.
Did you find it?
I actually did it a while back.
Unclaimed property. That's what it is. Unclaimed property in your state.
I did it a while back and got some money. And then this summer, I was sitting there in the warehouse, the kiln.
Yeah.
And Paul suddenly goes, "Hey, Jason. Did you ever live at?" And gives this address. It was the duplex.
Oh my God!
And I was like, "Yeah." And he goes, you are owed like $100 and something or something like that."
Wow!
I just haven't claimed it yet. It was from like a utility or something.
Sure, sure, sure. Yeah.
Or like cable or something. I don't remember.
Yeah.
You didn't get your deposit back.
What's that?
You probably didn't get your deposit back after you. And helpful hacks designed to help you
make this was the place that you own.
And give
you
the upper hand. Right.
This is hacking the system.
The deposit for the utilities.
Yes.
I thought you meant from you guys.
No,
saying, yeah,
for
we probably screwed you on the deposit.
I doubt that.
I thought that's what you were saying. Like, no. The duplex,
yeah.
Bonnie. You know. But no, you're probably right. Yeah. Probably something like that. But yeah, I forgot about it until just now. I gotta go check it out.
Major natural disasters.
According to estimates, the damages for those catastrophes totaled 125.
So that's it, man.
Yeah, hold on. I'm gonna tweet out hacking the system.
Oh man, what a crazy year.
Dude, yeah.
For you guys. Disaster that you didn't prepare
for. Big thanks to all of our cast, our crew, rather. Numerous guys, Ping Pong Production, Brad and Casey,
dude,
many thanks,
Brad and Casey, thank you so very, very much, thank you to,
Tiffany
Grant,
yeah,
who was the original person who reached out asking if I had any ideas to try,
don't forget, will be my life. Our very own Allison.
Oh, dude. Oh, yeah. Shit. I was going to... Should I show off
the
pitch doc?
Yeah, I don't see why not, right? And thanks to our art crew, Donnie and Sabina, Tony, and all of our PAs, Max and Jen. About Fargo? Yeah. I don't think we did. I'll tell it. Yeah, and of course producers Paul and Deb and everybody at the office and Adam, or excuse me, Alex, who we had on the show, and Steve. It's probably out in Palm Springs right now, kicking it by the pool. Yes, thank you for everybody. I'm sure we're leaving people out. Our amazing camera crew, Jimmy Faye and Kevin and Doug Cheney. Awesome guys. So we were talking to one of the guys in the art team. He wasn't there every day, but he was there quite a bit. His name was Tony. His last name is slipping my mind right now, but it's going to be easy to find in a second. I think Bonnie, you probably heard the story. A lot of people had been in show business in one degree or another for a long time. And Tony said, yeah, I was actually William Macy's son in Fargo.
Oh, yeah.
I was like, wow. And he's like, yeah, yeah. And he was in a couple of other things as well. And then Max, one of our PAs, he's like, I was in Matilda.
Is it a coconut? Oh, my gosh. Crazy.
Yeah, it was nuts. But I can't remember the...
I guess it's just an industry. I mean, you're in it. Like, people are, you know, the folks are in it. They're in it.
So,
thanks to all the editors and sound people that I didn't really get a chance to be around all that much. I think I covered everybody else.
Crystal was the one who put up with me shouting at all times. Thank you to Greg, who was in charge of all the editors, and I wish I could remember all the editors' names. I'm afraid to try.
Did get introduced.
No, I definitely went and shook hands because I'm like, I'm so sorry that all of you have to look at me over and over. By the way, here's the funny part. Any of you guys who have ordered anything from scamstuff.com and have seen this image stamped, this was all of these were bought for the purposes for the purpose of making this one document. We wanted to create a pitch document that looked like a Cold War era dossier. And so Bonnie, while she was pregnant with Calliope.
I was?
Yeah. I had you stand up on a chair so it would look like you were taking a photo from another building.
Yeah.
And I had you...
Neighbors don't think I'm weird or anything.
I had you take these photos.
Yeah. I'm like, Brian, I don't know. Okay, click, click.
I had you take these photos so that it looked like it was me being spied on. And then we took like the first half. We also did like a bunch of counterintuitive things. This is all Allison's work, by the way. Looks freaking exquisite. But you know, we would cover up giant chunks of it.
Redacted.
Yeah. We did like a bio page that looked like this, and ideas for episodes that looked like this, and then more ideas for episodes. But it's like,
as you can see, it gradually devolves into like a Unabomber manifesto.
Yeah, this is the thing. Like, this is our whole plan for the show, and we took a marker to it, and we just redacted giant chunks of it so you can't read it. And that was the whole idea, was like, this was meant to be a show about everything that you're not supposed to know. And,
And it really, that's the whole thing that sold it, was her work that just...
Absolutely.
Just made it visual and...
No bullshit, no lies. Like that's definitely in my heart. What I think happened was the polished nature of what we sent over. It was
just
amazing.
Like, we have a clear vision. Here it is. And good. Then, like, when they hold something that's just, that just says, oh, I get it, obviously, you know, then they can go with that. So, you know... All the chain yanks you had had before only went so far. So. Finding
clean water, the only thing we didn't have in there going in.
By the way, this is the last one. People are asking, like, why don't you sell those? And the answer is because this is literally the last one that exists. And, I made like 15 of them, maybe 20 of them at Kinko's. And then, that's it.
I love Kinko's.
So you just gave them out or lost them or what?
Well, I mean, I sent over 18 of them to Ping Pong because they were doing a round of pitches. So it's like one of these exists. Like, I know CNN was interested at one point. I know that, you make a compelling argument.
If you have a large family,
I think, or if you're without
water, CNN, dude, there was like seven networks interested.
Check out your hot water heater.
using a and I gotta tell you, man, I'm thrilled that it was Nat Geo that picked it up.
What were some of the other titles?
We had The Secret Knowledge of Brian Brushwood.
That's where it started.
Was the start.
Wait, that was Jason. Jason totally brought this thinking of a completely different project.
Dude, and then you had
around.
A fiction project.
Of course. Yeah. Defaulting to fiction. And that was what it was. We were sitting there talking about it, and I was like, you know, he does all of these things, and Brian was like, well, yeah, let's do that, but not fiction.
Not
narrative.
Fiction. Let me actually be that guy who knows everything.
I just loved it. I remember Brian telling me about their meeting. They're like, oh, yeah, and this is where we went with it, and I think that'd be awesome. And I was like, wow, that sounds like legs, you know, like that could go somewhere.
Dude, absolutely.
Sure enough.
But yeah, Hack of All Trades.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh no. Okay. So it was hack.
That's
what,
the one
Secret
I like.
Of Brian
I can
Brushwood,
see now. It's
hack of all
like,
trades.
I think it's so
how
much
to win
now.
At life.
How to win at life.
How to
yep.
cheat at life.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And eventually hacking the system. By the way, let's see. Yours, our chocolate. Fatty McElbows says you're thanking all of these people, but I want to know who set you off on your midsummer rant. I mean, I think that was almost certainly the whole Twit meltdown, right?
I'm not a good budgeter. Unfortunately, I'm a spender. I would love to learn more about finances,
investments, retirement. But that one got resolved.
Yeah.
And that was very.
But there were rants about it.
Well, yeah.
Ill-advised rants.
Yeah.
That two people in this room were telling you, shut your fucking mouth.
Yeah. And one was encouraging me and telling me how proud he was of the.
But I was also telling you to shut your mouth for part of it.
Fair enough. Look, there's a lot of rants, a lot of people. Who am I to say?
Oh, yeah. Hey, that all worked out.
No money in that, son.
Yeah.
No money in that, son.
Yeah.
Now he talks about honesty.
Yeah, okay. All right. Yeah.
Brian's phone starts blowing up from Bonnie. Stop.
Everything's fine.
And I'm coming in through the kitchen like, are you so stuffed looking up over that like, where the recording area was like, dude, what are you doing?
It's amazing. Dude, we got a few people under $100 who have responded. Holy shit. Thank you for helping me to find $400+. We love hacking the system.
Retweet.
Well done, sir.
Outstanding. Did you find anything sweet? No, I didn't think so because I had looked for you.
No money.
Did you check for me, too? Okay, I did. And then there's, not much, but a little bit. TransUnion.com makes it easy. Yeah. Mostly around Cork County, Ireland. Maggie Murphy?
Dude, there's got to be a million freaking Murphys out there, right?
Oh, wait. Did you check your other names?
All the names that you have?
Did you check all my names,
I just realized I have no idea what your main name was. Come to TransUnion.com and get in the net. Right on.
So what's your full name right now?
Wow.
Right on. What's your social?
What's your mother's maiden name? What's the name of your first pet?
Let's just give it all out.
Yeah, exactly. Good luck, fuckers.
Seb Gons, I am in the same boat as you are. I also. Dude, look at this. Joel Bush. Has $15, 3 entries, and wants to know if it's legit. And I'm like, yeah.
Oh, I remember Joel Bush.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. How awesome that he's in. He's watching. Oh, that makes me happy.
That's awesome. Wicked Tuna.
New episodes. Yeah, that's really cool.
Yeah. On the National very cool. What else do we want to talk about this experience? By the way, I'm very glad that they've replayed the disaster episode so many times. It's
Well, they had a marathon last Friday, right?
Yeah, that's what I heard. I heard there was like a marathon weekend coming up or something.
No, I really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh.
So I hope, I don't know, I hope to hear more. But
we should do this
again
for the
entire marathon. At the end of the day, man. Okay, think about how annoyed we are with how long The Hobbit is and realize we made more content than The Hobbit movie.
Lucky for me. What?
In way less time with slightly less money.
Less but, yeah.
Substantially less. Okay. If you want to be honest, we didn't quite have the budget of Peter Jackson and company.
Yeah. Which of these foods to eat now, that's insane.
But I didn't find out how to rule them all on your show.
Yeah.
That's why I'm really interested.
Hacking Mordor, season 2.
Season 2, yeah.
So here's the question, man. Warning of an emergency, like with a hurricane, hold on. Turn them to the lowest setting possible to build up a Bill Shields says, my sister won't claim her $1.82. I bagged around $400 a few years ago. Dude, okay. Let's fantasize real quick. If/when we get the call for season 2.
Oh, we're still talking about the show.
Yeah. So it's like you and I just roommated up and we're like an old married couple. Yep. But it was tough being away from the ladies for so long. Like would you want to get 2 different places or would you want to like get a Brady Bunch house?
No, 2 different places. Perfectly in different counties.
I don't blame you. Man,
I don't blame you.
I walk in, and I'm just like, oh, Brian.
What?
What?
Because, I mean, he's all like, got Jason doing his laundry.
Okay, well, first of all, Jason loves doing my laundry. Oh, he loves doing laundry in general and said, I like doing laundry.
I like ironing.
Yeah, no, Jason definitely did all that ironing.
Okay.
I like ironing, and I was just marathoning justified ironing.
Oh, yeah. You know, I kind of get that then. I get that.
He only hit me once when I overstretched it. To be fair, I really did.
Well, there was the incident where I had to explain that it's no wire hangers. That was a little bit awkward as I beat you.
Yeah. I deserved it, and he only did it because he loved me. That's all.
Oh my god.
No, yeah. If it comes around for a season 2, like. Get like a, like hey guys it's we're gonna need room for
I mean that's this dogs. Is what I'm thinking right because there's no way Bonnie can handle everything on her own but if we all did like a big group thing he looks awkwardly over at Allison how are you with taking care of kids who want to go to the beach
I already put my keys in the bowl oh with
like I just say we go full on like a Robert A. Heinlein you know blended family thing yeah Yeah. Are you kidding me?
I tell you, the Girl Scouts didn't work out, so I'm all...
wait until Josie comes home and says, I'm going to cut a fucking bitch who looks at me cross again. You're like, oh, that's Allison who has been...
that's sweetheart, we talked about this. That's Allison talking. That's not Josie.
What did you learn today? Fuck the man.
She's got a little girl that masturbates in her class, so it's like...
yeah, let's talk about that. Josie didn't know how to express it. She's like, she keeps touching her butt and smelling it.
Her butt, Borat would say, her front butt.
Front butt. It was definitely front butt.
Definitely.
No, tell the rest of the story. Make sure go.
Yep, let's get it all out.
Do it.
Okay. This is a special needs kid. So,
fuck you, assholes.
So, I mean, on the one hand, I'm totally I get it.
Justin Robert Young.
So, I mean, on the one hand, I totally like that they have integrated schools because, like, I taught art and you got everybody in there. And
white, Hispanic, chronic masturbators.
Yeah, you know.
Why not?
And it's like this condition with sensory things. And it's like I don't know, but like what the exact term is because they have all this privacy stuff. But that's what kills me is like, can we have a little less privacy? So, because I went and volunteered and I'm teaching in the classroom, and then I had to be there during this, and I was like, what the hell? Not prepared. Don't know what to do.
Masturbating in class.
Sure.
And then.
Not the best thing.
But then the thing that kills me is I have my older kid that I homeschool, and then people are all like, hey, you know, you got to make sure that your kids are socialized when you homeschool. I'm like, you want to talk about socialized?
Yeah.
Let me tell you what's happening at school, because I'll tell you how she's getting socialized. So. I don't know.
This may be the single best hack we did.
Yeah, this one's a neat one.
That's amazing to me. Like, I really can't believe that works.
Electricity!
Quite so clean as that.
Magic! Was it
Hurricane Katrina? Somebody sent you an image.
Yeah.
It's probably not one you want to
open. I do not click on that. Oh, Brian. She put a bonnet on it.
You like it?
His hands are definitely around his no-no square. You did. You took it. Phrasing? Allison taught me what the no-no square was.
No-no square? What? What?
That's where your hands are. That.
Oh, God.
In your no-no square.
I'm a bikey man in a bikey game. Living in a crack house, making crack.
So how long is this going to be on TV with reruns?
I'm super curious about that myself. I don't know, to be honest.
Oh, to the end of days. You know.
Forever.
Yes.
You'll regret this, yeah. Brushwood.
When
so many reruns.
Yeah, right before...
Wait, run that by us again. Say again. Dogs 31 airings over the next 2 weeks? We're like fucking huge.
That's a big deal.
Yeah.
It's a big deal.
Yes.
Samuel Hahnemann.
Yeah, dude, I want to dig that up, actually. Oh, dude, who knows?
Forever.
I mean, it's like, I mean, who are we to say? I mean,
April, May, maybe. I mean, that's what it was last time, so I'm just guessing.
Yeah, I don't know.
So I had an incident. I had an ear incident this weekend.
A near incident. Not an ear incident.
No,
near.
A near incident. We went to this restaurant and we're getting terrible service.
Yep.
And I was picking up an order to go.
What were you dressed like?
I don't remember. Normal, right? My Iron Fist.
Okay.
Right on, as one does.
Blue jean jacket. This
sure.
Jacket.
Sure.
Yeah, okay. So I was dressed like me.
Yeah.
But it wasn't a fancy restaurant. It's
okay.
One you guys have been to before.
Okay.
It's a Tex-Mex place, local Tex-Mex chain.
Yeah, all right.
Oh,
I bet
and
I
you're
can
picking
guess.
Up a to-go order.
Picking up a to-go order, so I'm standing at the bar waiting. And nobody's acknowledging me.
Yeah.
And then I pay for it, and I still don't have my food. And I'm like, okay, I paid a while back. Where's the goddamn food?
You know, yeah,
I'm waiting,
sure.
And everybody's just doing their thing. I'm just kind of standing there, and I'm like approaching critical mass, right?
Right.
It's about to be like, all right. I'm causing a scene. Where is my food? I was about to like. Is it okay to? I was about to cause some problems.
And.
And then. Hey, weird question. Are you on TV?
Oh!
No!
Oh
my God!
I was like.
What? You are not anonymous.
That
anymore.
Is my nightmare. That is my absolute nightmare.
I was this
me?
Close
me.
To like Weapon X. I was like, ah! Where's my food?
Yes.
Thug life.
That is amazing.
That is. So
oh, the Thug Life meme. Great, yeah.
Yeah.
yeah, I was like, I mean, I was like right there about to like just be an asshole.
Sure,
you know?
Sure.
And it would have been mostly justified. I probably would have been taking it a little too far. But he's like, are you on TV? And I'm like, yeah, I am. He's like, I thought so. Yeah, you looked exactly like him. I thought, that's got to be him. I was like, yeah, I don't get recognized very often.
Oh, my God.
Wait, what is this one?
Thug Life.
Oh, the cackling, like, yeah.
Oh, that's the cackling.
Yeah,
one.
That's the,
that's
I think
the
people
one.
Really like that one.
Wait, unless this is, no, yeah.
It's three, the, yeah.
Three, it's yeah. You cackling at
yeah.
me.
But yeah, I was like, oh, I don't get recognized. He's like, oh, it's a good show. I'm like, thanks.
Can I have my food?
I was just like, where's my fucking food?
Dude,
I didn't say anything. I was like, thanks. And then I waited for like another 5 minutes for my food. They should have been ready like 20 minutes before.
So we recorded a bunch of like stingers for the opening of Night Attack. And I told Justin the story that you apocryphally told me about the person who met Chuck Palahniuk at a signing event and talked about how awesome the people doing things to food segment was. And Chuck Palahniuk was like, oh yeah, no, I definitely did some of that. And he's like, well, like what? And he's like, oh, I don't want to say. And Chuck Palahniuk was like, oh, no, just tell me. And then finally he leans up forward and goes, Margaret Thatcher has eaten my cum.
That's right.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Seriously?
Yeah, right?
I was this close to being, oh, that asshole came into the restaurant, and he's a dickhead. He was yelling. I was almost that guy.
Do you guys think that maybe they're all back there just talking about you, watching you? They're all like, oh, wait, don't take his order out yet.
I'm not good
at
hiding my facial expressions and what I'm thinking. So they're probably like, oh, he's so pissed right now.
So pissed.
It was cold. Undercooked. It was a drag.
But, I mean, hey, they recognized you. That's awesome, right? I remember when Brian was on the Tonight Show, he went out to like the local bar. He's like, I gotta go out. I want to see if I get recognized, right? And so he goes out. And
I think I was there.
Oh, you were.
It was at Raggedy Ann's.
Yeah, right? You were.
Wait, this is when? What?
Which is still
when
around,
you were on the Tonight Show. Like you decided you had to go.
Oh, dude, no. He was my wingman.
Yeah, he was your wingman.
I'm telling you, you don't understand the history that Jason and I have. It's unreal.
Oh, so funny.
And we went to did you get recognized?
No.
One time. Remember,
we went to
three places, and there was one. There was one. There was like a fake out where one dude was just like, oh, no. Okay. There was like, we went to not Raggedy Ann's. I want to say it was Rack Daddy's. Before it was
Rack Daddy's.
It used to be something else.
Players. It was Players.
Yeah. So it's like, I'm there, and then somebody goes, excuse me. And I look, and I'm like, yes. They're like, I need to get out the bar. And I'm like, oh.
That's right. Yeah.
But then there was one dude who looked. It was just like, you were on there. And he shoves at his nose. And I'm like, yes, I was.
Yeah, that's right.
I put a tube in my nose on national television. Jeez. Yeah, why not, man?
Oh my God!
Project Mayhem.
Okay. By the way,
already on a watch list.
This moment right here,
I'm sure.
Josie describes the show. She's like, "Daddy, I want to watch the show." And I was like, "Which? What show?" She's like, "The one where you have like the stuff on you and you walk."
Yeah, she totally thinks you're
like,
awesome.
She thinks I'm badass looking in this homemade.
It's like my dad is Batman.
But then she was watching the one where you jump out of the van, and she was so horrified because he makes like a ridiculous face.
What did she say? She said
she's just like, she goes, why would you do that face in front of people? Which I'm sure she hears the teacher say that to another kid in the class.
Yes.
You know, why would you do that in front of people? I don't know, but she was like, oh my gosh.
That's amazing.
Oh,
dude.
Boy.
Okay, is there some part of you
maybe that wishes it was more powerful?
Well, maybe that's what I'm about to ask. But like, I mean, granted, we're not there, but doesn't some part of you wish we had used ghost peppers instead of red peppers?
Yeah.
Like, just to know, just because, like that was not bad enough.
It sucked. Don't get me wrong.
Oh no, it sucked. But not so much that we didn't try it a second time.
Yeah, and it's like, okay, we can kick it up a notch.
Yeah.
We could have.
Yeah. And, you know, just because, like, coverage is so weird. And it's like, the look on all the cameramen's faces where they're like, ah, did you get it? Yeah. And then we see that we open it up and are bleary-eyed for them to go. And it's like, you want another one, don't you?
Yeah, they're looking back and forth. Yeah.
They're like, it would be really great if we got another one. Yeah. It's like, God damn it. Potassium nitrate, aka salt. Yeah, it was amazing. Stump
remover, good times.
Alright.
Alright, we wrapping it up?
Yeah, I think we should.
Alright.
Dude, here we are. We're in the last few minutes of... Man, this is it. Wait, you said 31 more episodes in the next 2 weeks? Perfect.
According to Tech Wizard, 31 episodes and 10 episodes in the next 2 weeks.
I am so very okay with
and
all
and there's apparently like some sort of marathon. Maybe during this marathon, we should do all of them and drink the entire
like straight
time.
Through. We should do a drinking game. Like every time Brian says a fact, we drink. And then we
go, yes.
We've done a power day.
Hacking your liver.
Oh my god, that sounds horrible.
we can make limerick lemonade.
Okay, you guys. Oh, dude. I'm sure we alluded to it. Did we full on explain what limerick
lemonade
was? Oh,
yeah. Okay, no, we totally did.
Okay, we
what
did.
Is limerick?
Limerick lemonades was Jameson and Crystal Light. They were called Limerick Lemonades, as named by Tom Merritt when he came to visit.
Tom.
Us.
Yeah.
Tom comes over, he goes, yeah, Limerick Lemonades. And we're like, wait, what? He was like, that's what I'm calling them.
Yeah. Because like, oh. We were calling them Arnold O'Palmers.
Yeah. That's what we were calling
that's
them.
So yeah.
And then Tom said Limerick Lemonade. Well, like, yeah, that's better.
Yeah,
that's
way better. Way better.
So are these like. Good or are they just yeah. like ghetto?
They're
like,
actually surprisingly.
Like,
I mean, number one, they're definitely they're ghetto. But number two, they're also definitely good.
Bonnie, we are discerning drunks.
Okay.
This is what we drank all summer. You right. know they're good.
Cranium says everyone should tweet out their favorite part of season one.
Yeah,
I agree.
Hashtag hacking the system.
Hashtag hacking the system. You know what? I will. In fact, I'm going to tweet out. They're like, water, like gas and electricity. Holy FEMA cow. Recommends that you have enough food, water, and supplies full to last season your family through this crucial period. Out.
I'm so ashamed of myself.
Why?
I immediately thought, it was kind of cool that he tackled that snake. I'm like, no! That's irresponsible and bad behavior.
Wait, what are you talking about?
Huh?
Would you expect any less from Snake Dick Brushwood?
Oh, Brian.
Was that it? This is the second
season? Yeah, man.
Oh, wow. Well. You're so fast.
Out now. What was your favorite part of... It should come back up. Of... Hashtag hacking the system. Boom. Look at that. Autocomplete.
So yeah, now available on Hulu.
Yeah.
On Amazon, albeit a little bit difficult to find. On Google Play. On Xbox Video.
Dude, 2 episodes
iTunes.
On YouTube.
2 episodes on YouTube. Legitimately on YouTube.
Also, like, I'm just going to say, like, if you're going to look for it, might as well go to YouTube.com and just search Hacking the System. I'd be curious with what came up.
Yeah.
Let's see. I'm gonna do that right now. Hacking the System. Ah, well.
Hey, there they
are.
Whoa. Wow.
Look at all that. That's some stuff.
One of those is legit.
I wouldn't think less of your audience.
I'm just saying.
Well,
wow.
I don't know. I mean, we've got a lot of people.
Yeah, don't forget Hulu. Chaos Bulldogs, like, hey, wait.
Yeah.
Yeah, Hulu. No, we mentioned Hulu what? For sure.
Oh,
yeah,
you did.
Absolutely.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, which look. There's a playlist. Look at this. There's
damn.
Some stuff. Right on.
And then some other stuff that's not even
crazy.
Remotely.
Yeah, that's fine. It's fine.
Oh, there's an ISIS training video.
It's fine. Let's just scoot on ahead. Dude, thank you everybody who joined us for this amazing experience. What an extraordinary
yes.
journey. This has been very much looking forward to seeing what we do in 2015.
And thank you very much for all your support. And thanks for showing up, especially you diehards. You know
Patreon.
We know who you are.
.com/shut the fuck up. This wasn't funded by Patreon.com.
Oh my god.
See you guys. Love you. Sex or religion, come on. Enough day to day stress is just living. We ain't giving a fuck. The hate it just cause they're different. Let's do it under the name of the love that became lost. Dress it up, how you want it, cut from the same cross. Scars of hate, crown stitched to our faces. Can't escape the cage we forge with the bars to break. For those living every bit of the struggle, giving a hustle, trying to figure how to fit in the puzzle. And right now we in pieces and pieces. The people as one, to them we're treated love, we're speaking in tongues. And here we go. I am, you are, we are one. We're two sides of the same coin. We drink from the sun. We be the left hand, right hand.
Tight like we kicking the drums, it's like we speaking in tongues. But no book burnings of church sermons. I serve currents, my words burn like a dirt furnace. Confusion leads and anguish sells. But this music succeeds where even language fails to convey. Free, honest expression is a problem. Trying to get people to acknowledge progression. My goal is to leave a lasting icon.